By me seeing that someone's got a lot of gifts does not mean that he's close to Allah. By me receiving a lot of gifts does not mean I'm close to Allah. If you think that Allah has given you a nice house, Allah has given you a nice salary, Allah has given you a nice job, Allah has given you a nice wife, nice kids, or a nice husband, and you feel that alhamdulillah, everything's going good for me, that means Allah must love me. No. That's no sign that Allah loves you and does not love the one that has got a shanty house, who lives in a part of the town that is not, people don't want to live in, who has got a wife that moans at him, who's got children that are, coming in and out, banging the door every time when they're coming in. He's got no peace in his life, who's got bills that he needs to pay and his salary doesn't cover it. And you try and compare yourself to him and you say that Allah loves me and Allah doesn't love that person. You are absolutely wrong. If you think that Allah loves me, Allah must love me because of me being able to, because people tell me, people said to me, mashallah, you're a person, you're a good person. You've got a good heart. You're a good brother, mashallah. Everyone likes you. Everyone loves you. Everyone wants to know you. If you think that that is a sign that Allah Azza wa Jal is close to me, you are wrong. You are wrong. If I think that, I'm absolutely wrong. People, doesn't matter what they think on this earth, no matter how much they praise you, you might be a person that is, in the eyes of people, someone who is, who hasn't done anything wrong. And they are always saying good things about you. And they're saying how much of a wonderful person you are. And you might think at the same time, when they're gossiping bad about somebody else, that means that person, he must be someone who's a bit away from Allah. No, that is wrong. We don't make such judgments. Wealth on this earth does not show Allah's love. Wealth, whoever has got wealth does not show Allah's love. Whoever's got good izzah, dignity, you've got a nice, good family, good name, your whole family is dignified in the community, it does not mean that Allah Azza wa Jal is close or far away from you. It does not mean anything. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jal has done the same thing for kuffar. He has done it for those people who don't even believe in him, who swear at him, who say rude things about him. Allah has given them wonderful houses. Allah has given them a lot of dignity. Some of them He has, some of them He hasn't. It's just like the trees that grow. You try and see any field, you won't see any tree the same. You won't see that 10 trees, you put 10 seeds here. 10 seeds here. And you put them apart, maybe 2 meters apart. 10 seeds. They're the same size seeds, exactly the same weight you put them inside. On that piece of ground, the same rain has come down. On that piece of ground, the same sun has shone over a number of years. But when those 10 trees grow, will they all be exactly the same height? Yes or no?
No.
They will not be the exactly same height. See, this is Allah's doing. You try and build, if you take wood, you take the same piece of wood, you try and take the same carpenter, you tell him to make the same thing, he'll make you 10 same objects. You look at the pillars, you see, the architect or the builder has made these pillars, he's made the same pillars, equal size, equal height, all of that. This is what a human being, this is how we think. But Allah Azza wa Jalla doesn't look at things like that. When He wants to give something, He gives it. Allah said, يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Whoever Allah wants to, He will expand their wealth. And whoever wants to, Allah will decrease it. It's not about what you think or what I think. It's about what Allah thinks. Now Allah doesn't judge us from these things. So what's my point? My point is, there are many things that we think of why someone is close to Allah is wrong. How do I know that I am close to Allah Azza wa Jal? How do I know that? It's a big question. How do I know that? Am I close to Allah? It's a big question. Am I close to Allah or not? So I shouldn't look at the gifts Allah has given me. I shouldn't look at the things that I've got. I shouldn't look at the blessings that Allah has granted me. No. What should I look at? What I should look at is this. Is that the heart that you've got, and the heart that I've got, the heart that you've got. There's a love inside there. There's a love inside there. And there's hatred inside there. That love that I've got inside my heart, for the things that I love, do they match the things that Allah loves? Does my heart, the love, the things in my heart that I love, are they the same things that Allah loves? And the things that I have in my heart that I hate, are they the same things that Allah hates? And that's number one, that's point number one. Point number two is, the things that are in my heart that I love or hate, how many times throughout my day, throughout my week, month, and year, does it continuously match the love of Allah? And the things that I hate in my heart, how many times throughout the day, throughout my week, my months, my years, does it match continuously the hate that Allah has for things? How much? On that scale, if you were to measure yourself, then you know how close you are to Allah or how far you are from Allah. Now, I'm saying something here for us to all really seriously think about. So for example, everyone here who's sitting here, you all love Salah. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no? Come on.
Yes.
Yes. We all say yes, we all love Salah. Today, Asr time, everybody has come here. If you didn't love Salah, you wouldn't be here unless your dad hit you one and made you come here, right? That's a different thing, okay? But you love Salah, so you came here, fine. So on this occasion, Allah loves Salah, my heart loves Salah, so I have come to the masjid and I have offered my prayer, Alhamdulillah. And then after that, Maghrib, yes, we love Maghrib. Isha, we love Isha, Alhamdulillah. But what about a night when my eyes are feeling drowsy, my body is tired, my heat in my body is high, and I really, really need to go and rest, and the pillow is just there, and the bed is so comfortable, and the temperature is just between 21 and 23 degrees, and it's going to be so nice, just for 10 minutes if I go there before Isha. And the shaitan says, you know, I'm not gonna hear him, but the shaitan says, just lie down. Now the time of Isha comes. So what's Allah's love? Allah's love is what? Allah's love is that I get up for what? For Isha. And then my love in my heart, inside me says, 2 more minutes, 3 more minutes. I'm still awake. 4 more minutes, and next minute, gone. I might be asleep. Has my heart on this occasion met with the love of Allah on this occasion? Yes or no?
No.